So I'm pretty sure that you guys already heard about this, but in Japan, there are services where guys can pay for girls to talk to them, which I know is kind of hard to understand, but Japan is a culture, you know, their birth rate is declining. People don't really go out and date or get married. Working over there is more important and they have no time for dating. So services like girls talking to you, pretending like you're on a date, you know, people pay for that stuff. So anyway, these services, you know, they range, you know, there's like different types of services. The most popular one is called the maid cafe, where pretty much, you know, you go to a cafe, you get a coffee, and the people who serve you your coffee are maids. You know, they are girls who are dressed up in like a maid outfit, you know, really short skirts. They look really cute, you know, have a lot of makeup, and they act like I guess like anime girls. You know how you see like girls in anime, you know, like with little streaks, being all cutesy and, you know, just adorable. Well, they do take on that personality. And when you go to the maid cafe, you gotta pay by the hour. So you're paying to be at the cafe so you can talk to the girls there. And they are very nice. You know, I've been to one personally and they do talk to you and they try and conversate with you. And they do try and sell you more like drinks and stuff. You know, you can buy, besides coffee, you can also buy like beer and stuff. So anyway, the maid cafe, it was all right for me. Like I thought it was, like it's kind of expensive. I only went like twice because my friends wanted to go, but it's not really worth it in my opinion. So another type of service that you can pay for is called like a girls bar. Now a girls bar is pretty much the same idea. You go to a bar and you pay money to be at the bar so girls can talk to you at the bar. So one time I was with my homies and I was walking downtown, and I always walk by this one bar where there will be a bunch of girls at the window at the bar and they'll be waving at you. They'll wave at you to come in, you know. They of course look really cute. So I always walked by this bar, and every time I walked by it, there will be girls again waving, looking all cute. Sometimes they will be outside trying to get you to come inside. So after like the 20th time of walking by it, I decided, like I told my friend, I'm like, you know what, let's go inside, man. I've never been inside a girls bar and I want to see what it's like. So I go inside and pretty much I sit down at the bar, and one of the girls at the bar, one of the bartenders, she brings out a menu and she told me to read the menu, you know, because the menu has like rules that you have to follow. So I got the menu, and pretty much what the menu said is it pretty much outlined everything that you can't and can do. So some of the rules that the menu outlined is you cannot touch the girl. You're not allowed to touch her or anything. Another rule was you cannot ask the girls for their contact information. So you can't be asking them like, yo, what's your number? What's your social media? No, none of that. You are only allowed to conversate. You're only allowed to have conversation, but no touching and no asking for their personal information. And it said if you break any of those rules, you will be kicked out by the security. I mean, it's pretty simple. You know, you pay to sit there, have some drinks and talk to girls, but you're not allowed to do anything else with them, just talk. That's all you are allowed to do is talk. Now, who would pay for this? A lot of people paid for it, man, because a lot of people in Japan are lonely and they want someone to talk to them and listen to what they have to say. You know, maybe you're having a bad day at work, you want to go get a beer, you just have someone listen to your problems, right? And you know, there's lots of bartenders, a lot of female bartenders. The only guy workers there are like security to make sure you are following the rules. So anyway, you know, girls get assigned to each guy. So you know, I sat down with my friend, and that one girl, she got assigned to me and my friend. So she was there and she only paid attention to me and my friend. She didn't go with anybody else. She didn't go and serve anybody else. She was there, she sat down and she looked at us from across the bar and she talked with us directly. And you know, that's what she's paid for, you know, to communicate to, you know, one person or a couple people, and that's it, you know, entertain certain people or one person until they leave. So you know, she was there talking to me and my friend for like the whole 1 hour, and you know, it was a good conversation. You know, she asked me about my day, she asked me about like where I'm from, what I'm doing in Japan. I asked her about, you know, a little bit about her life. You know, we just conversated like friends. You know, it was like a good conversation. You know, I was making her laugh, she was making us laugh. And then after an hour, she told us, she's like, yo, your hour is almost up. So do you want to pay for another hour to continue this conversation? Or, you know, do you want to leave? And at that point, I'm like, you know what? No matter how funny or entertaining we are, this bitch is just getting paid to talk to us and pretend that she's laughing or whatever, you know? It's all fake, is what I'm saying. It's all fake. It's fake as fuck. But, you know, people like it. So me and my friend, we did pay for another hour, and you know, after like 2 hours, we're like, you know what, we're calling it quits, man. And pretty much after we left, we each paid like almost 100 bucks each almost $100 each just for those 2 hours. You know, we were drinking, you know, we got our beers and we got like some free, you know, nuts, but pretty much paying for that, it wasn't worth it, man. It wasn't worth it. But I get the appeal, you know, I get why people go, but it's something that's not for me. Like, I wouldn't do it by myself. I wouldn't go, like, you know, I would go with friends, but I wouldn't go by myself. Like, I don't think it's worth it. Really expensive. I'd rather just go to like a regular bar and try and talk up some girls over there instead of paying for them, you know, just a waste of money, man, in my opinion. But I get it, you know, I get it. It's a service and it's a popular service. Now, I know a lot of people know about those services in Japan. It's kind of weird, I get it. But what threw me off and what kind of blew my mind is that there are also boys bars where a girl pays to go to a bar and pays to talk to a boy, right? Now, how would that make sense, right? Why would that make any sense? Girls can just go to like a regular bar or a regular club or a regular anywhere and have random guys go up to them and talk to them, you know? Why would a girl go to a bar and pay to talk to a boy? That doesn't make any sense, does it? It took me a while to wrap my mind around it. I'm like, how does that work? Why do boys bars exist and how do they make any money? Well, as I want walking downtown, me and my friends always noticed that there would always be these guys, a bunch of Japanese dudes dressed up in suits with like fancy colored hair, kind of like anime guys, kind of like K-pop stars, I guess, you know, like long hair, dyed hair, you know, like bright orange in a suit. And they would always try to talk to the girls that would walk by them. I mean, it'll be like a group of 10 of these guys, you know, 10 guys in suits, long hair. And every time girls would walk by them, they would try and talk to them. I never understood them because they were talking Japanese, but then I understood that they were advertising for the boys bar. All right. So some of the things that these guys would do to advertise is like they would go up to random girls and sing to them, you know, they'll go up to them and be like, I can show you the world, you know, like that, and the girls would just laugh and keep walking. So I would see these guys in these suits trying to advertise and the girls would always just laugh it off and keep walking. So I'm like, again, how do they make money? Girls don't really seem to be interested in them, you know. Then one time, for the first time, me and my friend were walking and there was like these two girls walking together, like we were walking behind them, you know, we're walking, and then one of these guys in their suit, they go up to the girls and they say something to them. The girls smile, they look at each other and they're like, yeah, let's go. So this guy takes both of these girls to the boys bar. And I'm kind of thinking like, wait, how did that happen? How did they make, like, how did that one guy make that magic happen? You know, and the girls went with it, you know, they actually went with it. And it was the first time I saw a bunch of girls go with him, with one of these guys. And I'm like, dude, like, here are two foreigners. Like, dude, I like, my Japanese sucks, but I'm willing to talk to you girls for free. Why are you paying some guy to go talk to them? You know, again, I'm trying to wrap my mind around it. But then I kind of understood how they get business. I kind of understood like how they are making money, you know? So one time I came back from, you know, downtown and I was going back to my room and I saw two of my classmates, two of my homegirls, you know? So I came back and they were pretty drunk. So I went up to my homegirls. I'm like, yo, how you guys doing? Where were you guys at? And they're like, oh, we were drinking, having a good time. And I'm like, oh, really? Because I just came back from, you know, downtown. I was also having a good time. And they asked me what I did and asked them what they did. And I'm like, so what do you guys do? And they're like, pretty much we spend the whole time, the whole night at a boys bar. And I'm like, wait, hold up a minute. You went to a boys bar? They're like, yeah, you know, all giggly. I'm like, why do you guys go to a boys bar? Why would you pay to go talk to a guy? And they're like, well, first we saw them on the street, but they offered us a free beer. You know, if we went to the boys bar, they gave us a free beer. That's what got us in. I'm like, all right, so that's how they lure the girls in, you know, come to the bar and we'll give you a free beer. And I'm like, all right, cool. And I'm like, why do you guys stay? And they're like, well, the guys, you know, they're all really cute, really sexy. They sit with you, you know, they shower you with compliments. And, you know, sometimes some of the guys were a little bit naughty. They'll start talking about sex, but they were like, they would sing to you, shower you with compliments. They were really nice, you know, give you all this attention. And I'm just kind of like, okay, I get it. So that's why girls go, you know, to go get that attention and those compliments, you know. But again, the same rule with the boys bar. Girls, if they go to the boys bar, the boys who work there looking all sexy in their suits and singing and stuff, they are not allowed to touch the girls or ask for their information. So pretty much they went there to go get a free drink, one free drink, and then get showered with compliments. And they said that they did pay for the 2 hours or 3 hours that they were there. And they did pay like around like $100. So around the same fee that I paid when I went to the girls bar. So yeah, it surprised me that girls actually do go to the boys bar to pay money to talk to boys. Really surprising for me, man, but it's a service that girls do pay for. The service for boys, where boys pay to talk to girls, I get it, but it took me a while to understand why girls would pay to talk to boys, which I kind of get now. I get it, you know, it's an attention thing, you know. I guess that's all I wanted to say on video. I mean, I have nothing else to add to that. It's just kind of surprising to see that kind of stuff go on in Japan. And some of my foreigner friends who did visit me from America, they said that they would be interested in going to a boys bar just to see what it's like. Even though they are not really interested in paying to talk to boys, they are interested to see like what the boys bar is like. You know, they pretty much told me that it's just like, I guess, like a fun thing to do with friends. So I kind of get that too, you know. So you go to Japan, yeah, you're gonna see all these services everywhere. Another popular service is where guys rent girls. Like there'll be like a store, man. You go inside the store, and there'll be like pictures of girls everywhere, kind of like a museum. And then you find a girl you like, you call up the number, she comes to the store, she picks you up and she takes you out. Pretty much you're paying to hang out with a girl. Paying to hang out with a girl. No sex or anything like that, it's just paying to hang out with them. So these stores, you know, like I saw them all the time. You walk downtown, it's like a little store. There's no employees in there, it's just a bunch of pictures like a museum. Call the number, they come pick you up, you hang out, you know, pay for the hours to hang out. You pretend you have a girlfriend or whatever. And then after like your time is up, you know, they just go back home and that's it, dude. It's weird, dude, it's weird, but I saw it a lot, dude. It's weird, but I saw it a lot. But anyway, that's all I want to say. You know, let me know your thoughts, drop a comment. If you want to see more videos like this, you know, let me know. I like talking about Japan and my experiences in Japan. So if you want to hear more about my stories and stuff, you know, subscribe. All right. And yeah, I'll talk to you guys in the next one. All right. Peace out.